Hawaii Department of Transportation has fleet of Teslas that is helping the state save money. Can other states save money as well with Teslas or more electric vehicles? In this report, we're going to take a look at that, how Hawaii Department of Transportation is saving money with Tesla. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to our channel and ring the bell so you don't miss my next Tesla coverage, as I do several a day. And give us thumbs up, please, for this video and share in social media. Let everyone see how transportation departments across the United States are saving money with Tesla. Jonah Kreider from Clean Technica has some details talking about KHON2 having a few concerns about Hawaii's decision to outfit its State Department of Transportation, DOT, with a fleet of Teslas. The news station noted that it was receiving a lot of questions about why there were so many Tesla vehicles being used by the State Department of Transportation in Hawaii. Apparently, state fleets should look worn around the edge and not like luxury vehicles. Their outlet, Always Investigating, asked State Department of Transportation Deputy Director at the Highway Division, Ed Sniffen, a few questions. I really appreciate the concern that you have to make sure that we are fiscally responsible, said Sniffen to the news station. We're not looking at purchasing luxury vehicles. We're not looking at trying to pamper our employees. I would love everybody to understand that we're looking at the best deals for the state. We could have considered optics and opted for the Chevy Bolt, but we would have gotten a less reliable vehicle at a higher cost, he said to the news station. Sniffen shared the numbers, explaining that the fleet of Tesla vehicles came out at $1.49 per mile when you consider telematics and charging stations. Nissan Leaf came out at $1.60 per mile, and Chevy Bolt comes out as $1.70 per mile. So Tesla vehicles with $1.49 is cheaper than Nissan Leaf and Chevy Bolt, which are coming with $1.60 and $1.70 per mile respectively. Panos Prevodorus, a UH Manoa Engineering School transportation professor, thinks that those numbers aren't correct. When they tell you that the per mile cost of a Tesla is lower than a Nissan Leaf, that really does not compute, Pavrodelos said. So there may be other fixed charges that there are we don't know about. Somebody is making some good bucks out of this between the contractors and Tesla and all, he said. Sustainability Partners, a contractor that handles acquiring the Tesla vehicles and charging station components, noted that this is part of a new model for Hawaii's fleets called Mobility as a Service. This model enables state and county agencies to electrify their fleets for a pay-per-mile usage fee. Sniffen explained that the Hawaii Department of Transportation procured a Chevy Bolt that cost the department around $50,000 for the vehicle. The charging station cost us another $15,000 to $20,000 to install the infrastructure for the charging station, then install our racks and everything like that. So overall, total about $70,000 when we finished up. And still, maintenance is on us. Still, insurance is on us. Sniffen noted that the cost would have been $2 million with the latest fleet replacement, but the new approach is much better. Because the Teslas were the best deal, we got 43 Tesla vehicles. But when you go out for the next bulk purchase of vehicles, it's whatever vehicles are available and whatever technologies that gives us the best deal, he explained. He also explained that the Department of Transportation of Hawaii will save hundreds of dollars on fuel even after the cost of power, and that the department would be driving greener. Prevedorus, however, noted that the grid isn't as green as Sniffen thinks it is, and pointed out that around 80% of Hawaii's electricity is dirty. The argument that we're saving CO2 really shouldn't be even on the slide. It's too early to try to claim that, he said. Now, Jonah Kreiders, the editor, has a note on this, saying this is an odd claim. It is well documented, thoroughly proven, that driving electric vehicles is much greener than driving fossil fuel vehicles. Yes, 100% cleaner renewable energy is better than 20%, but an electric car is already much greener than a gas-powered car and gets greener year after year. So, another perk of the Hawaii Department of Transportation having a fleet of Teslas is the ability to track and verify that they are being used for work assignments. A few employees will be allowed to take them home, but they won't be allowed to use them after hours besides for their work commutes. Now, here are examples of how switching to Tesla from fossil fuel vehicles saved police departments money. Tesla's reputation as a luxury brand often has the public pretty confused. The idea of taxpayer funding buying a Tesla seems insane to those who don't follow the company too closely. However, Teslas have low cost of ownership and can actually save money, and many local and even state governments are realizing the benefits of having Tesla vehicles in their fleet. Here's a quick list of few examples of such that Jonah Kreider details in Clean Technica. Let's take a look at the example of the Fremont Police Department using Tesla vehicles. The Fremont Police found that the total cost of ownership for their Tesla Model S85 not only decreased over time, but that the vehicle holds its value twice as well as the average fossil fuel vehicle. Another study found that the average 5-year depreciation of Tesla Model S85 is 61.77% and possibly 80% after 7 years. When you consider the additional age and the intense driving that police vehicles do, this decreases the total cost of ownership by a range of $12,000 to $13,000. Now, here's the example of Westport Police Department. In 2019, the city of Westport in Connecticut added a new Tesla Model 3 to its police vehicle fleet, angering city critics who again chastised the department for buying a luxury vehicle. Westport released data on the cost of ownership, and an analysis of the data showed that the town of Westport was able to pay off the extra investment within the first year. Wow, within first year. Even further, the Tesla police vehicle will have saved Westport $63,000 after 4 years of an amortized basis, enough to buy another one. Bargersville's Police Department. Bargersville in Indiana added a Tesla Model 3 to its police fleet well over a year ago, and the cost of comparison between the Tesla Model 3 and Dodge Charger showed a savings of almost $7,000 in 1 year. The cost of operation for the Dodge Charger for a year was $7,580, while the cost of the Model 3 was $825. For fuel and maintenance costs, the Model 3 saved the department $6,755. After a year of owning the Tesla Model 3, Todd Bertram, the Bargersville police chief, shared that he loved the vehicle. Although these are just 3 case studies, Jonah Kreider says in Clean Technica, more police forces have started utilizing various Tesla vehicles for their fleets, and in time, they will also share the data on their savings. Teslas may have higher upfront cost and may seem luxury, and depending on the department's use, may require additional costs for modification. However, in the long run, the savings and benefits will typically prove those costs as wise investments. Well, friends, let me know what your thoughts are about Tesla vehicles. Do you think police departments, departments of transportation making the Tesla vehicle purchases is a wise or luxury vehicle purchase? Let me know, please, in the comment section below. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. Have a great day, everyone. Please subscribe to our channel and ring the bell so you don't miss my next Tesla coverage. And also give us thumbs up, please. Share in social media so everybody sees that Tesla vehicle purchase is not necessarily luxury for the government because it's based on our taxes, but a cost-saving measure and also clean air for the cities and counties. Have a great day. God bless you, everyone. Peace be with all of you. I'll see you soon in our next Tesla report.